Let us give the Lord some praise. Hallelujah. Amen. Yes. On the last day of the year, the Lord has spared your life. Oh, you ought to give the Lord some praise. Yes. He spared your life to see the last moment of 2022. And he allowed you to be in your right mind. And he allowed you to be blessed and honored and favored. I don't know about you, but I am blessed. To our other wonderful assistant, amen, Reverend Eloise Gladden,
yes,
praise
yes.
the Lord. To Minister Eugene Gladden, God bless you, God bless you, God bless you. So good to see you, amen.
Hallelujah.
And last but not least, to the Skip to the Loo, my darling, amen. To my Snow White, looking all beautiful in her beautiful bright white, amen. To the prettiest First Lady in all African Methodism, Sister Michelle Yvette Simpson. We give the Lord praise on what's night Eve. Amen. On what's night. Let's give the Lord some praise. Amen. So at this time, we're going to turn it over to our wonderful worship leader. Amen. The Reverend Linda Sumter, and she will lead us forward on in this wonderful worship experience. Let's give the Lord some praise.
Yes. Amen.
Amen, amen. Glory to God. Oh, we thank God. We thank God this afternoon is this hour of the night. Amen.
Yes, amen. Amen.
When I came into the place, when I came into the sanctuary tonight, God says grateful. God says grateful.
Yes.
How many of us are grateful?
Yes.
Truly grateful
yes.
tonight.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Thank
how many
God.
Of us are truly grateful tonight? Hallelujah. Even though we may have had some rough times, we had some bad. If you'll be grateful, he'll do it for us.
Amen.
God is a good
Amen.
God, isn't he?
Yes.
God is a wonderful God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. God said there will be signs and revelations. He said be of good cheer because he is already overcome. I'm grateful tonight. The Bible says the enemy is getting for thanksgiving to his cause with praise. Are you ready to praise him tonight?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
What he is here. Praise him. Hallelujah. He's my love. How you may be feeling tonight.
Yes.
This building tonight.
Yes, yes.
All we got to do is just open up and let
Amen.
The Lord have his way.
Hallelujah,
hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, yes. We know. We know another year is coming in.
Yes.
But we need to be grateful tonight.
Yes.
We need to show God that we are grateful for all
Amen.
That he's done
Amen.
For us.
Yes.
And what he still yet is going to do for us. We need to know that God is still in the blessing business. God is still in the blessing business.
Yes, he is.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah anyhow. I'm going to say hallelujah anyhow. Can you say a hallelujah anyhow?
Yes,
no matter what
yes.
is going on in your life, are you going to say hallelujah anyhow?
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
God is a good God.
Yeah.
I just don't know what you come to do.
Yeah,
but I came to praise him.
Yes.
I came to lift him up. I came to leap for joy. I came to let the Lord know that I love him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's what kind of God we serve.
Yes.
Hallelujah. That's what kind of God I serve. If you serve the same kind of God that I serve, give him some praise in here tonight. Give him some praise. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. It's good to be grateful. It's good to be grateful. It's good to be grateful.
Yes, it is.
When you look around and you see things happening in your
Thank
life,
you,
it's good
God.
To be grateful.
Yes.
Because it could have been the other way. Hallelujah, but God got us here at this appointed time just
thank
to praise him,
yes.
just to lift him
yes.
up, just to glorify him, just to give him some thanks tonight.
Hallelujah.
You're going to give
thank
him some praise
God.
Tonight.
Yes, yes, yes. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, God.
Hallelujah. 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 Because the earth is the Lord, and the fullness thereof, and all that dwells therein. We are dwelling in the Lord's place. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. His temple.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
I'm going to give him some glory tonight. I'm going to give him some praise. If the Lord tell me to get out there and shout, I'm going to shout tonight. Hallelujah. I'm going to shout my troubles over tonight. Hallelujah. Whatever I may be going through, I'm going to shout my troubles over. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm going to give him what he surely deserves.
Hallelujah.
He deserves all of our praise.
Hallelujah.
He deserves all of our goodness and mercy. He deserves all of our praise tonight. He deserves it. How many of you know that he deserves it?
Yes.
If you know that he deserves it, give him another hand clap.
Hallelujah.
And say hallelujah anyhow.
Thank you,
sir. Hallelujah anyhow.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah anyhow. I thank God this afternoon, this hour of the night, for just allowing me to be here.
Yes.
I tell you, it was some struggles today. I went through some stuff, and sometimes things make you get a little aggravated. Make you think that you're not going to be in the midst of God's people. But God will open up some realness, and he'll push you out to where he needs you to be.
Yes.
I know he will. I've seen it, and I know he'll do it.
Yes.
Won't he do it?
Yes,
yes,
he will.
Yes, he will.
Yes, he will.
Won't he do it?
Yes, he will.
Yes, he will. He'll do it.
Yes, he will.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is just that type of God.
Yes.
Grateful.
Great.
Grateful.
Yes.
Grateful. No matter what it looks like. No matter what it seems. No matter what you're going through. This time of the evening, be grateful. God said he's going to do some things in here tonight. He's going to show forth his glory. All you got to do is just open up and let him come on in.
Yes.
I'm going to let him come on in. Yes. He's already in me now, but I'm going to let him. I'm going to let him have his way.
Yes.
Let him have his way tonight,
yes.
Church.
Hallelujah.
Let him have
Thank
his way.
God.
Amen. Praise God from whom all blessings flow.
Thank you. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, yes, God. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Don't call the roll. I want to get right with God for myself, but don't call the roll, God.
Amen.
Every heart praying, God, Father, in the name of Jesus, I just want to say thank you, Lord. Thank you, as humble as I know how, oh God. Lord, I continue to move and set free, Lord. Move to suit yourself tonight, oh God. But Lord, thank you for letting us see another new day and a new year, God. For we could have been dead and gone, but Lord, you said no, in Jesus' name. And Lord, defeat is defeated in Jesus' name. And everything that come against us is defeated.
Hallelujah.
In the blood of Jesus, we say thank you.
Thank you.
We just want to say thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord, without you, where would we be, oh God?
Oh, yes.
Oh, thank you, Jesus, for another day, another territory.
Hallelujah.
And Lord, thank you for letting me see another night, oh God.
Thank you.
If I could have been dead and gone, Lord, I ask you to look over my family, Lord, in our time of bereavement. Continue to set free, deliver, and be a keeper, Lord. As you promised, but we know you're going to be because you're not a liar, Lord.
Yes.
And we say thank you for that tonight.
Thank you,
for being a truth and set free.
Yes.
We say thank you in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Lord, Jesus' name.
Oh, God, come and have your way tonight, God. We say thank you. We just want to say thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Nothing else I can say but say thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Move to suit yourself tonight, oh God.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. Let the Holy Ghost power come in here.
Jesus.
Suit yourself tonight, oh God. And we say thank you for that in Jesus' name. Come on and put those hands together and say thank you, Lord. Jesus, I'm praying. Amen.
Thank you.
Thank you.
presence of Almighty God. Look at your neighbor tonight and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Brother O'Shea, we are glad to have you here, and thank you for blessing us tonight.
Amen.
And I'm sure everyone has enjoyed it. At this time, it's just so much that's been happening within like Christmas Day, and we want to continue to pray for Brother Witherspoon. Also, Brother Nathaniel Johnson lost one of his family members on is one day is due to a drunk driver, and two of them, well, they're putting up two hands. So I know one was buried on Thursday, and one died Thursday. So he went to that funeral and went home and died. All right, Brother Johnson, we're going to keep you in prayer. And also to my sister-in-law, Audrey. Her father died on Christmas Eve, and we laid him to rest today. And I'm asking prayers for my oldest brother. He lost his four-year-old grandson on Christmas Day. So they will be traveling to New York within the next couple of days to lay him to rest. And 2 days later, that same train came back by for Brother Walter Brown Jr. So that's, anybody know that Sister Martha Stooks, Sister Lula, Sister Eva, that's their brother. And he will be laid to rest on Monday at 12 p.m. Also, we're going to continue to pray for Sister Lizzie Kitt. She's still in the hospital, and family's asking for prayers for her as well. And anyone else who are, you know, sick, you know, we are praying for you as well. On Wednesday night, our Bible study will continue at 6:30 p.m. And also, if you were born in the month of January, I've gotten some names, but on next Sunday, Pastor's gonna be blessing y'all, and y'all names will be showing on live screen right there. With the, just your name and your date. We don't need to know the year, so you can you can give that to me or either Sister Demaja, and we'll have that displayed as Pastor saying happy birthday to you. At this time, we'll turn everything back over to the pastor.
Amen. Let us give the Lord some praise. Amen. And let us continue to govern ourselves accordingly with the announcements that have already been mentioned. Amen. And the pastor really does not have any observations tonight. My heart's desire is to preach us into the new year. We need a word from the Lord. Amen. God is getting ready to do magnificent things in 2023 in your life. Amen. Do you believe that, church?
Amen.
Amen. And God is getting ready to tell you that you got some greater works waiting on you. You just got to just buckle your seatbelts and hold on for the ride, because God is getting ready to blow your mind. Amen. And also to add to the names of those persons who have been sick and shut in, amen, Sister Janie Oliver. She's in the hospital. She has been in the hospital, and we want to pray for Sister Janie Oliver as well. And those persons who have lost lives over the holidays, someone in an accident, two persons passed away, amen. Let us at this time just have a moment of silent prayer, amen. And let us be careful as we continue to try to make it through the holidays, amen. We know that we have common sense that God has given us, but sometimes we have to use our common sense for some others who are not using theirs, amen, while you're driving up and down the highway. So let us look to the Lord for silent prayer to properly memorialize those who have lost their lives over the holidays. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. And as I prepare to take my seat, amen, I'm going to let my worship lead, amen, drive this train all the way up until it's time to preach, amen. But thank you so much, Brother O'Shea, for dropping in, amen, and blessing us with your gifts and talents, amen. I love hearing that steel guitar, amen. So if you never heard a steel guitar before, now you've heard what a steel guitar sounds like. And it does wonderful, wonderful things for your wonderful worship experience. God has answered my prayers, and I believe with all my heart, the Word of God teaches us that the Lord inhabits the praises of His people. Amen. And when we start praising the Lord, you know, the Lord, He will get into your praise. And don't you know that's when miracles will begin to happen? If we would just loosen up and just praise the Lord, that very thing that you've been looking for the Lord to do for you will happen sooner than you think. But when God inhabits our praises, He will let healing happen in your lives. He will let miracles fall from the sky. Do you believe me, church? Amen. Amen. And so the Lord, He's beginning to add to what we're already doing with praise and worship. Amen. Praise is powerful. It's a powerful weapon to put the enemy under our feet. Amen. Amen. Let me tell you, I almost feel like preaching right here, but somebody needs to hear this. See, when you are praising the Lord, when you're going through hell and you don't show any tears in your eyes, don't you know that confuses the devil? Amen. He's looking for you to give up. Yeah. He's looking for you to cry. He's looking for you to turn your back on your life. But when you start praising the Lord, guess what? That confuses the enemy. And guess what? The Lord, He will do great things in the midst of your struggles. Amen. So keep on praising the Lord as we go into 2023. Yeah. God bless you. Turning it back into the hands of our most capable worship leader, the Reverend Linda Sumter.
Amen. God is
so awesome. And I tell you, it is the truth. When you start praising of God, inhabits the praises of His people.
Yes,
and a lot of us, we just keep our mouth shut. And when we start praising Him, awesome things happen. God has things already out in the atmosphere ready for you, just to throw at you. Because these things has happened to me, and I thank God for Brother O'Shea, because I used to tell Pastor, I said, Pastor, every day when I would go to work, when I was working, people would talk about my Olive out the programs. Everybody would be talking about it. Everybody, I want to come there. I want to hear it. I want to just be in the midst. And they talk about the colors, and they talk about
All right.
May never see you skipping a beat. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. When they see you walking in God's power and authority, yes, hallelujah. Hallelujah. When they see you paying your tithes anyhow, when you like lost your job, when you want to have a job, hallelujah. Mm. God says, I'm going. Ah, God. I'm going to open up some windows. Right now, Lord God. Oh God, we praise you right now, Lord God, for allowing us right now, God, to have the mindset, God. Oh God, to have the ability, God, because you said you're the one that give us that ability to get wealth, God. Oh God, and we thank you right now, Lord God, for that ability to get wealth right now, Lord God. And God, we are honoring you now with our first fruit, God. And God, we thank you right now, God. We're going to give you glory. We're going to give you honor in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. Amen. We thank you, Jesus. Somebody say, thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Now that we get ready, all right, for the dynamic choir again, senior choir. I tell you, they're doing, I tell you, God's even a few. All it takes is a few. Some of us sit back and God want to do a work in our lives. I can't sing. I don't want to be up there around them. That's an old choir. You know, I Now we're getting ready for the senior choir to come back up, the mighty senior choir to come back up and sing us, sing our pastor. Our pastor is already happy. And he's already given out a pathetic word. Y'all will be listening. Pastor already gave out a pathetic word tonight. Did y'all listen to that?
Hallelujah.
I'm not going to even repeat it, but I wonder if you heard what he said. All you got to do is just praise him. God has already inhabited your praise. He's going to inhabit your praises, Sister Witherspoon. I don't care what it looks like, what it may be, what it seems. God says, I'll turn that situation around.
All right, now.
And it don't always have to be money. Exactly. But God says, I'll turn that situation around. I'll make it work for your good.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So without further ado, I'm getting ready. I'm excited because Pastor's coming up with a word. With a real word. With a word for the beginning of the new year. Right. That's going to bless us mightily. Say, preach, Pastor, preach.
Preach, Pastor, preach.
Oh, man, that's so loud. Oh, that's lame there. Preach, Pastor, preach.
Preach, Pastor, preach.
We all get together. We came here to
Musicians, let's give the Lord some praise for them. Amen. But when we all get together, we're going to tear up some carpet and have a good time in the name of the Lord. Amen. Indeed, it is preaching time, my brothers and sisters. Amen. And before we get into the Word of God, we only have about 38 minutes left before we see the brand new year. I don't know about you, but if you hadn't gotten your shout on for what the Lord has done for you all year long, you bet not allow these minutes to pass you by before you give God your best praise for how he's taken care of you all year long. I just want to look over to my left and to your right. That's my baby boy over there now. Amen. Stand up, little Malcolm. Now he got my name, and as you can see, he got my face and got my smile, but he got my wife's dimples. Amen. She gave him a little something, but I gave him all of that. Amen. That's straight up Simpson right there. Amen. But it's so good to have at least one of my children in the house of the Lord with me this night tonight, amen. And my oldest son, he had to play for his church tonight, so he wasn't able to make it, amen. And Mount Olive, I want you to pray for my family. You know, the Lord is so good that he spares lives. And my mother-in-law, my sister-in-law, they were in a car accident on yesterday, and we spent all night long in the hospital, and we didn't get home till 6 o'clock in the morning. But you know, God is faithful, and he is good. Because we know my mother-in-law, she's home right now. My sister-in-law, she's home right now. And they're all right. Amen. So sometimes that goes to show you, don't you take the Lord for granted. Because just at a snap of a finger, you could easily lose your life. But there was a word from the Lord, and we are going to try to get to about 11:50. And we want to count the new year in. Amen. Do it in proper style. Amen. Let us go back to the gospel according to St. John chapter 14, and I'm only going to read verse 12. Amen. Verse 12. And I'm going to use the Holman's Christian Standard Bible version, and it reads this way. I assure you, the one who believes in me will also do the works that I do, and he will do even greater works than these, because I am going to the Father. Thus ends the reading of God's word. Pray with me as I use as a thought for our New Year's Eve message. Greater works are yet to come. Greater works are yet to come. You need to look at your neighbor tonight and say, neighbor, greater works is getting ready to come. Look at somebody else and say, neighbor, greater works is getting ready to come. Let us pray. Lord, keep on doing what you've done all year long. But Lord, do it in an extra special way tonight. Because Lord, we want to please you and not ourselves. We want to do greater works in your name like your word says. For it's in the name of Jesus the Christ we all pray. And the saints of God all said, amen. Now, I'm not going to be preaching very long, so if you bat your eyes, you may just miss the message. So you want to just keep your eyes focused on God's word. Amen. Greater works are yet to come. Greater works are yet to come. Greater works are yet to come. That is the theme for Mount Olive AME Church this annual conference year. And John chapter 14, verse 12 is our theme scripture. Mount Olive, you need to meditate on that all year long because the Lord is expecting you to do greater works. Themes, they keep us focused on what is expected to happen or what we are expecting to accomplish. It's like a brief mission statement regarding the goals we have set for ourselves. I know that we're getting ready to go into a new year, and some of you already done set some New Year's resolutions. Some of you are planning to get in shape, and some of you are planning to lose weight, and some of you are planning to do better by saving your money, and some of you are saying, I'm planning to do better by going to church. Amen. But I want to ask you all a question tonight. In fact, I want you to ask yourselves these questions that I'm getting ready to lay on you. First one is, so I want you to say it to yourself. I want you to say it as if you're talking directly to you. What do I expect to happen in 2003? And the questions are on the monitor for you to read for yourselves. If you got your cellular phone, you can take a picture of those questions. And as the year goes along, you can use those questions as reference questions to help you reach your goal. But what do I expect to happen in 2003? Are you just looking for it to come and that's it? You should expect to see something happen in 2003. What do I expect to accomplish in 2003? You should expect to accomplish something. You should expect to be able to buy a new house in 2003. You should be able to expect to buy a brand new car. You should expect to improve your health situation. That's an accomplishment. What do I expect in 2003? The next question is, do I have a vision? I'm talking to men now. If you have a family, every man needs to have a vision for his family. I'm just going to let that rest on your desk. Every good God-fearing man, young and old, should have a vision for what you want your family to live in, look like, and be like according to the will of God. Do I have a vision and a goal set for my life that I plan to achieve? If so, what are they? And if not, why? If you don't have any visions, if you don't have any goal, that is a problem. That means that you are just living from day to day, minute by minute. You have nothing scheduled or planned for your future. And when the Lord calls you home, guess what? You won't have a thing to leave your children. Why don't you have visions? Why don't you have plans for your life? Whatever your vision and goals are for 2023, I want you to be mindful that they should inspire you to go on and do greater works that glorify God. That's the underlining point right there. Whatever you have in store to do for 2003, it ought to bring glory. Y'all don't hear me tonight. Y'all not going to pray with me, but I'm going to preach this anyway. Whatever you expect to do in 2003, it needs to bring glory to the one that opened your eyes this morning, not your alarm clock. It ought to bring glory to God, because only that which we do for the Lord will last. But according to the passage of Scripture, Jesus' earthly ministry is now coming to an end. You got to go back and read John chapter 14. Just like this year is getting ready to come to an end and you're getting ready to see a new year come, Jesus, his earthly ministry is getting ready to come to an end. And he's been with his disciples all the way up to this point. He's been with them in the thick and thin. He's been with them when they didn't understand. He's been with them the whole time. He was with them when he was healing the sick and giving sight to the blind. He was with them all that time. I almost feel like staying right here, because God is trying to remind you. Sometimes we get so ungrateful and we forget that the Lord was with you. When you were rich, the Lord was with you. When you were poor, the Lord was with you. When you was well, the Lord was with you. When you were sick, the Lord was with you. Oh, you didn't get to this point by yourself. It was the Lord. Look at your neighbor and say, it was the Lord. But he has been with them up until this point. And here it is. He is nearing the end of his earthly ministry, and here it is. He sets two expectations for his disciples. If you look at that little short verse in verse 12 where it says, "Surely, surely, I say to you," the King James Version says, "Verily, verily, he who believeth on me, the works that I do shall he do also, and greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto my Father." That is an expectation from God to his disciples. God is expecting something of you tonight, Mount Olive AME Church. What is it that he's expecting of you? Have you ever thought about that? What is God expecting of you? But here it is. We're going to break it into here. The very first expectation is, do the work that I do. That's an expectation. In other words, that's the least that we can do. That's the bare minimum. Do the works that I do. That's what Jesus is telling his disciples. And the next thing he says to them, do even greater works than these. In other words, he's telling them, not only do I want you to meet the expectation, but I want you to do better. You need to exceed the expectation. You need to do better. Look at your neighbor tonight and say, neighbor, you need to do better. Look at your other neighbor and say, don't you take that personal now. But some of you need to be told, you need to tighten yourself up. You need to do better. You can do better than what you're doing. Or you just getting by. You just sleeping on yourself. You just cheating on yourself. And God is trying to tell you, you need to do better now. Y'all don't hear me tonight. I only got a few more minutes left, but we're going to get to the finish line. But let me make my first point. See, Jesus, I'm going back to the first expectation. Jesus, he tells
tells his disciples, if you believe in me, you would automatically do the works that I do. Let me say that again. If you really believe like you say that you do, you would automatically do what thus saith the Lord. That's the least that we can do, which is the bare minimum for believers. If you're a believer, you would automatically do what Jesus did. In other words, Jesus is expecting us to be real about what we say we believe about him. So many people say, I'm a believer, but guess what the Bible says? That even Satan, he believes and he trembles. But guess what? Satan ain't going to follow Jesus. Can I get a witness tonight? If you believe in Jesus like you say that you do, your walk would only match your talk. We always like to talk what we say about Jesus, but you need to walk out your words. You need to walk out your beliefs. You need to walk out your values. People would rather see a sermon than hear a sermon any day. Can I preach this thing like I feel it? Can I preach the bare minimum? The bare minimum that Jesus is saying, he that believeth in me, the works that I do, he would be doing also. Well, what did Jesus do? What's the bare minimum? If we say we believe in Jesus, we ought to forgive as Christ forgive. Y'all don't hear me tonight. If we say that we believe in Jesus, we ought to love as Christ love. If we say that we believe in Jesus, we ought to treat people like Christ treat people. You can't treat people any kind of way and say that you love the Lord. You can't treat people like hell and expect God to pour you out a blessing from heaven. You've got to treat people right. If you believe like you say you do, hallelujah, you ought to be true to yourselves like Christ is true to himself. Don't be fake and phony. You ought to be real. If you say you love the Lord, let it be real. If you say you serve the Lord, let it be real. If you say you're going to lean and depend on Jesus, let it be real. If we say that we believe in Christ, we ought to glorify Christ like Christ glorified the Father. Oh, we got some glory stealing people in the world today. The minute they get rich, they get like King Nebuchadnezzar and they say, look at all the money I got. Look at all that I have done. Look at my this and look at my that. But when the Lord pours you out a blessing that you don't have room enough to receive, you ought to take your little hand and say, Lord, to you the glory belongs. If it wasn't for you blessing me, I wouldn't have what I have. This joy I have, I didn't give it to myself, and the world didn't give it to me, and the world can't take it away. I got about 13 minutes to finish preaching this word, but all these things are the least a believer can do in Christ. But let me tell you something, church. I'm getting ready to get to doing greater works. Do you want to do greater works for the Lord tonight? Are you looking to do greater in 2023? Well, you need to listen right now. I'm fixing to tell you. I know that's not good grammar, but I'm fitting to tell you how to do greater works in the name of Jesus. Jesus gave his disciples some unbearable news. You've got to listen to this now. See, you got to go back and read verse 1 of chapter 14. He says to them, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. He's given them some bad news, and they don't feel that they're going to make it. But Jesus is trying to tell them, you've got to go on, even though I'm going on to my Father. But he gives them some unbearable news. He's expecting them to do even greater works than the bare minimum. Somebody should have caught that right there. He's expecting you to do more than the bare minimum. In other words, he's expecting them to do better. He's expected them to exceed the expectation. Let me tell you something, church. Can I help you out tonight? Just showing up for church whenever you feel like it, it's not enough to exceed the expectation. Just being on the choir, is not good enough to exceed the expectation. Just ushering at the door, is not good enough. Y'all don't hear me. Just counting the money in the finance room, that's not good enough. Maintaining a church property, that's not good enough. And just holding a position on the auxiliaries is just not good enough. Who am I preaching to this morning, this night and this morning? Who am I preaching to? Because expecting us. Jesus is expecting us to do better than that, because that's the bare minimum. I'm almost done. I don't know about you, but I'm ready to go to the next level. I'm ready for the Lord to take me higher. But there's certain things, that we got to do if we expect to see greater things happen. In order for the disciples to exceed the expectation, they're going to have to go on without Jesus in the way that they're used to being with him. You didn't catch that. Let me clean that up for you. They were used to Jesus being around them in his earthly ministry. They were used to Jesus raising Lazarus. They were used to Jesus. He was taking fish and 5 barley loaves and multiplying them. They got used to that. When you got used to Jesus doing the same thing, you're in trouble. But they had to learn to get used to a new way of doing Jesus. So to do greater works, it's going to require us to get out of our comfort zone. Yeah, that just went over your head. You get that when you get home. It's going to require us to get uncomfortable. It's going to require us to put on some tough skin. It's going to require us to put on some thick skin. When you get checked for not doing better, don't take it personal. It's the Lord's way. I'm trying to tell you, I'm trying to take you someplace. When you're going through to a new level, you've got to get away from all familiar things. Those things that you're familiar with, you've got to get away from that. Those things that you feel comfortable with, you're going to have to leave those things behind. Those friends that you felt comfortable being around, you're going to have to leave them behind. In 2023, who am I preaching to? If you're trying to do better, there's some people that can't walk with you. If you're trying to do better, there's some people that can't pray with you. If you're trying to do better, there's some people people that can't ride in your car. There are some people in your life that's holding you back. But I'm here to let you know tonight, in the next few minutes, the Lord is getting ready to take you higher. See, to see greater works, you're going to have to change the way you pray in 2023. To see greater works, you're going to have to change the way you sing and praise the Lord. Y'all don't hear me. You can sit there and look at me funny, but the Lord is trying to tell you, if you want to see greater things, you're going to have to change the way you serve the Lord in 2023. If you want to see greater works, don't you want to see greater works? Don't you want to see greater works? Don't you want to see greater works? You've got to change some things. Leaders in the church, you've got to change your leadership style. You've got to evolve in 2023. You've got to change how you see the vision. You've got to change how you set goals. I'm almost done. But let me tell you something. How can I activate greater works? Well, I'm glad you asked. In 2003, the way you activate greater works, you're going to have to call somebody's name. I ain't talking about your mama, not your daddy. I got a fine wife, and I love my son, but I got to call on that name that's above every name. You've got to call on the name of Jesus like you never called him before in 2003. That's why Jesus said, when I'm no longer with you, in the same way I used to be, just call my name. The Lord is trying to tell somebody, when you don't see me, just call my name. When you don't feel me around, call on the name of Jesus. You need to call on the name of Jesus. If you want to see greater works, call on the name of Jesus. If you want to see healing come, call on the name of Jesus. Call on the name of Jesus early in the morning. Call on the name of Jesus when you lie down. Call him in the afternoon. Call him just before you lay down at night. Call on the Jesus, that God, that Jesus. He's able. Yes. Yes, isn't God able? If you call on him, call on the name of Jesus. Call on the name of Jesus. Just keep calling until you see greater works. Just keep calling. Just keep calling. Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, 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 yes, Jesus, I need you, Jesus, I need healing, Jesus, Jesus, yes. The way you activate greater works in your life. I'm getting ready to help somebody out right now. The Lord is speaking to somebody right now. You're still trying to figure out how to see greater works because you don't understand. But Jesus is saying to you right now, you've got to call on the name of Jesus in 2023 in a different way. You can't do it the same way you did in 2022. You're going to have to change how you call on the name of Jesus. Amen. If you want to see greater works happen in your family, parents, you're going to have to learn to call on the name of Jesus over your children. If you want to see greater works in your church, you are going to have to learn how to call on the name of Jesus in your church if you want to see greater works happen in your church. But you can't do it the same way, my brothers and sisters. You're going to have to change up because the devil is always adapting and adjusting to your strategies. And you've got to adapt and adjust to his. Amen. So let us stand all over the church. And I'm done preaching tonight. I don't know about you. I don't know about you. But I want to see excellent things happen for God's people. Amen. Don't you want to see excellent things happening for God's people? Don't you want to see your children doing excellent things? Don't you want to see your family doing excellent things? Don't you want to see your community doing excellent things? But it starts with the church. Meeting the two expectations. We have got to do what we got to begin to start doing what Jesus did. And then we're going to have to start doing greater works on top of the expectation, which is the bare minimum. So as we are nearing the end of another new year, hallelujah, we've made it to 10 minutes till 12, amen. And I'm going to have my watchman to get in place, amen, Brother Sam Brown, you're my watchman. But just in case, if there's someone under the sound of my voice that does not know Jesus as your Lord and your Savior. You know, I work at DJJ, and I had a good Bible discussion with my kids, hallelujah, on Thursday morning. And they had all these questions about what happens if we don't accept Christ and we die. Where do I go? How do I reverse that when I die? And my answer is, you don't. You have to get it right now. And we only have about 9 minutes left. And we'll be in 2023. Don't let 2023 come and not save. Hallelujah. Listen to all the death that we heard mentioned across the church. Brother James Myers, he came to church tonight, and the deer jumped right out in front of him. And he was standing right out there in the parking lot, making sure that his insurance company knew about the accident. Now, if it would have went the other way, he wouldn't be singing on the choir right now. The Lord spared him. Hallelujah. You got to think about that. So if you don't know this man named Jesus, we invite you right now to come give your life to him. Will you be saved tonight, the last day of the new year, the last day of 2022 before the new year? Will you be saved? Don't you want to be saved? Don't you want the Lord to give you a one-way pass to his kingdom? Well, all you got to do, as the Bible says, confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God the Father raised him from the dead and be saved. Will there be one? Hallelujah. Won't you come? Amen. 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 We got about 7 minutes. Amen. Praise the Lord. And we're going to get ready to start the countdown, praying in the new year. Amen. Amen. Maybe you're not a member of any church. Amen. And it was by design that the Lord allowed Brother O'Shea to come and played with us tonight. He rode past his church several times and he dropped in. Amen. Now he says he has a church already right now, but we don't know what the end will be. But there are too many funerals right now being held in funeral homes. You need to be a part of a covering that prays with you and prays for you, and where you can receive the sacraments and the word of God, amen, with a family that prays for you. So if you're not a member of any church, we invite you to come right now. Come on and join Mount Olivet and Me Church. Come and join our family. Amen. Will there be one? Story, this is my song. All the day long. This is my song. Amen. And this is how we make the last petition. But we're ready to get into prayer right now. Amen. So I want you to listen to me closely. Amen. We want to bring the New Year's in praying. Amen. I'm not going to ask you to come all the way up here and kneel. Amen. So here's what I want everyone to do. I want you to turn around and kneel at your pew where you are. Amen. You may turn at this time and kneel if you're able to kneel. Because we want to bring the New Year's in calling on the name of Jesus. Amen. 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 Praise Jesus. Amen. On your knees, for this is the position where greater works will begin to happen. Hallelujah. Amen. Everyone kneeling all over the church. Amen. And as we prepare to start praying, amen. Watchmen, are you in place? Praise the Lord. We're going to cut the lights off all over the church. And as we are cutting the lights off all over the church, I'm going to teach you the true meaning of Watch Night service. Watch Night is all about us black folks. Amen. When the Emancipation Proclamation was about to come into effect into the new year, the slaves, they hid in the church because they're afraid that their slave masters were going to kill them. So they hid in the church. And that's why we black people come to church. That's why we do that, young people. They hid in the church waiting for the new year to come in and be free. And that is our tradition. Before it was Watch Night, it was Freedom Eve. And now it is known as Watch Night. And so we cut the lights off all over the church. And we will begin to start praying in the name of Jesus. But we only have 3.5 minutes left. And what are you expecting the Lord to do? Amen. Because the Lord, he expects things of all of us. And God, he wants you to trust him. He wants you to try him. You ought to expect the Lord to do something in your life right now. And I don't know about you, if you trust the Lord enough and you expect him to do great things, I am crazy enough to believe that he will let it happen. Amen. So, Brother Watchman, as you watch the clock, amen, we shall begin to pray. Let us pray all over the house. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Oh, that wonderful name of Jesus. There's power in the name of Jesus. So much wonder-working power in the name of Jesus. Healing power in the name of Jesus. Life-giving power in the name of Jesus. Miraculous, wonder-working, miracle power in the name of Jesus. And all we have to do is call on the name of Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Lord, when we call on your name, we remember what you did for us all year long. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Countless times, all throughout the year, Lord, you healed our body. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Lord, when we were hungry, Lord, you fed us, oh Lord, because we called on your name. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Lord, when we didn't see our way, oh Lord, you made a way out of no way. All because we call on your name. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Lord, the more we call your name, oh God, the better we begin to feel, oh God. The more we call on your name, oh Lord, we know possibilities, oh God, are sure to happen. Lord, when we call on your name, oh God, we know that you will make a way out of no way. When we call on your name, Lord, doors that have been closed in our face, oh God, you will open doors that no man can close. And when we call on your name, you'll close doors that no man can open. God, when we call on the name of Jesus, for your word says that if we ask anything in your name, you do it for us right now. So, Lord, we ask right now in the name of Jesus. Somebody right now at the name of Jesus is praying that the children would get saved. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Somebody right now, Lord, is praying for someone that is sick and they're looking for them to get well. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Lord, we praise you when we call your name, Jesus. Lord, we worship you when we call your name, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. 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 Oh, we feel the devil getting mad right now when we call on your name. Because the devil already knows he's still lost the battle. He'll never win because we've learned to call your name in a new way, Lord. We've learned to call on your name in a way that the devil can't understand. We've learned to call on your name. We've learned, yes, we learn to keep calling your name even when we don't feel like it, Lord. We'll keep calling your name because the more we call your name, the more you get the glory. You get the glory out of our healing. You get the glory out of our blessings. Watch night, watchman, what time is it? Amen. We have reached 2023. Let us stand all over the church and call on the name of Jesus. We made it to 2023. Call on Jesus. Call on Jesus. Call on Jesus. Jesus, thank you. Jesus, thank you. We made it, Lord. We made it. Jesus. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Yes. Yes, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Yes, Jesus. Amen. Come on and praise the Lord. Amen. 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 Somebody say Jesus. Amen. You just activated greater works in your life when you call the name of Jesus. Amen. At this time, we are preparing to bring the New Year's Eve, bringing in the New Year's, receiving the body and the blood of Christ. Does everyone have a communion vessel? Amen. We want everyone to have the body and the blood of Christ. Amen. So please make sure, raise your hands. We want everyone to receive the blessing of Almighty God. Amen. Amen. By way of His Divine Holy Communion, it is so good to see so many children in the house of the Lord tonight. Amen. The Lord is answering my prayers. I'm saying, Lord, please help me to understand and figure out what I can do to figure out why we don't have that age group in church anymore between the ages of 45 and under. And the churches are dying because we don't have these babies in church. Amen. My heart is smiling tonight. So when you pray, God will answer your prayers. And I've been praying, Lord, send the children, Lord. But I've also been praying, said, Lord, show me what to do with them when I get them, oh God. Give me something to give to them to do. Amen. Does everyone have a communion set all over the house of God? Amen. Let us all stand all over the house of God as we prepare our hearts, souls, and minds to receive the blood and body of Christ. You that do truly and earnestly repent of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors and intend to lead a new life following the commandments of God, and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith in your spirits, remain in your seats, amen. And take the holy sacrament to your comfort, and make your humble confession to Almighty God by meekly kneeling in your spirits right where you are. You may be seated. With a clean and sincere heart, let us now recite the general confession. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed by thought, word, and deed against your divine majesty, provoking most justly your wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us. Most merciful Father, for your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in the newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of thy great mercies has promised forgiveness of sins to all them that with heart of repentance and true faith turn unto thee, have mercy upon us, pardon and deliver us from all our sins, confirm our faith and strengthen us in all goodness, and bring us to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto you, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty Everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we loud and magnify your holy name, evermore praising you, and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Glory be to you, O Lord Most High. Amen. Lord, we do not presume to come to this your precious table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather crumbs from under this your blessed table, but you are the same Lord whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful souls and bodies may be made clean by his death and washed through his blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us. Amen. Let us stand all over the house with your vessels in your hands. Take the bread, the body of Christ, and break and eat right now. For it is the body of Christ broken for you. You may eat now. And take that vessel and peel back the second layer. For it is the blood of Christ that was shed for you. For blood and water ran down the streets of Jerusalem when they pierced the men inside. Drink now, be thankful, for it is the blood of Christ. Amen. Let us now recite the Lord's Prayer in unison. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Amen. Yes. Amen. Let us be mindful that we have a wonderful repast that has been prepared just for you. Some grits, some eggs, some sausage, some bacon, some coffee, and some orange juice. Amen. And we want to bless the repast, and you are all welcome to help yourself in the fellowship hall to receive the repast after we bless and receive the benediction. Let us look to the Lord in prayer for the blessing. Lord, we made it to 2023 to receive our first meal, O God. We thank you for it, O God, and we dare not take it lightly. Thank you, Lord, for preparing for us, O Lord, this food, O God, with consecrated hands. And we pray that you will bless those hands, O Lord, that prepared the food. Lord, bless this food that once we receive it into our bodies, we pray, Lord, that it gives us divine strength to go on and do greater things in 2023. And now let's receive the New Year's benediction. May the God who gave us this year and the Savior who walked at our side each day and the Spirit who filled us with life abundance grace the coming years with peace, hope, and joy. And the blessed people of God all said, amen. Happy New Year's, Mount Olive. Amen.